Welcome in to a moment of reflection with the Pickerington Church of Christ. This time together is devoted to taking what we've learned from the sermon this past Sunday and discovering how we can practically live these truths out in our lives. We encourage you to grab your Bible, sit down with some friends or family, and join together with us as we reflect on the Word of God, how to obey it, and how it can change our lives. Well, welcome in, family. I'm so glad you're joining with us tonight for this moment of reflection. We're spending a lot of time in Hebrews right now on our Sunday morning lessons, and I hope that you're getting a lot out of them. Hebrews is really the fifth gospel in the New Testament. We've got Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, which tell us so much about the stories of Jesus and his teachings and the big events that really shaped history. But Hebrews is a book that really gives us the essence of what Jesus means to us. And the underlying theme throughout all the book of Hebrews is that Jesus is greater than so many different things that we think about with regards to relating to God. So this past Sunday, we were in Hebrews chapter 7, where the Hebrew writer was really not letting us off the hook with understanding Jesus as our greater high priest. And what he's doing in this letter is showing us how Jesus is the greater fulfillment of the roles of leadership that God's people had under the law of Moses. There were really three main roles that God's people had to serve them while they were living under the law of Moses. The first one was a prophet, the second was a king, and the third was a priest. And we learn from Hebrews and other places throughout Scripture that Jesus is the greatest version of all of these. He is the greater prophet, greater than Moses even himself. Moses told us that God would raise up a prophet like him for us. And Jesus is that greater prophet. And the role of the prophet was to speak from God to his people. And Jesus has most certainly come here to speak to us from God. The role of the king was God's administrator, overseeing his people and orchestrating the leadership that God's people needed. And Jesus, from the line of David, became the king who would sit on the throne forevermore. And here in chapter 7, we learn that Jesus is the greatest high priest. And what's unique about him is that he doesn't come down through the line of Aaron. Aaron was the first high priest, who was Moses' brother. And from his lineage were all the high priests that ever served the Israelites. But in Hebrews chapter 7, we learn that Jesus came from the order or the line of a guy named Melchizedek. Now, Melchizedek, we learn about him in the book of Genesis. He was the king of Salem, which is really the city of Jerusalem, long before it was ever called that. His name means righteousness. And we learn in Hebrews 7, he was the king of righteousness. And he was also the king of peace, which is what Salem means. And what we learned about Melchizedek is that he didn't have really any record of his parents. We don't have any record of him dying. And in that way, being a king, but also acting in a priestly way, he met Abraham and received from Abraham spoils and a tithe. So Abraham offered to him, much like a person would offer to a priest. And the Hebrew writer tells us Jesus is like Melchizedek, no beginning and no end. Truly a king, but also a priest. There's some important things I want to share with you about Jesus being our priest to make sure that this really hits home for us. First, it means that we are reconciled to God. The priest's work was from the people towards God. He ministered for the people to God. And because Jesus was chosen and appointed by God to this role, because he never dies, he lives forevermore, and because he has an offering himself that is acceptable to God, we can be sure that we are reconciled to God. We also have confidence when we pray. We are able to pray through our mediator, Jesus Christ, because he is the true and greater high priest that ensures our connection to God has been made whole. We also can have peace of mind. When you know Jesus as your high priest and you know that you're reconciled to God and you know that you can pray with confidence, that is a gift to us from God to have everlasting peace of mind. It reminds me of what Jesus told the disciples when he said, "Peace I leave you, my peace, not peace from the world, but my peace I give you because you are in me and from me." The last one is this, though. Jesus as our high priest means that you and I, as disciples of him, have now become a royal priesthood. There's a passage in 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9 when Peter's trying to explain to the Christians there what they're supposed to be like. And he says, you are a holy nation, and now as disciples, you are a royal priesthood. You see, priests were the people who were called out from the nation of Israel to be the people who served God daily. And because Jesus now is our high priest, you and I operate in the world as priests who serve God daily. Our role is to help a watching world who may not know who God is through Christ come to know God through Jesus. Our job is to serve them by serving God. Our job is to care for people and to lead people to know who Jesus is, the great high priest, and ultimately to be reconnected to God. Every one of us have been called to this role as a high priest. This is not just for elders of the church or a preacher in the church. This is for every single member. If Jesus is our high priest, we have been called to the service of the priesthood of God. So this week, I want to encourage you to practice being a priest, which simply means serve God by serving all people. Help them learn who Jesus is, display to them the love and the beauty of Jesus, and minister to people and minister to God in a way that brings glory to his name and helps people see the greatness of his love. Have a great week.